Yo, people. So, another one. Following on from the Akil is Tupac video. Whilst researching it, I didn't know before I started researching it, because as I said in that one, I had to comprehend that one. I also found this one, and I'm 100% confident that Biggie Smalls, Notorious B.I.G., is now Soup, aka Zaakir, from the Jurassic 5. Now, this one hasn't blown my mind as much as Tupac being a kill, because I guess that sort of prepared me for this, but it's still mind-blowing. You know, both Tupac and Biggie Smalls are not dead and are playing the roles of other rappers. So let's get straight into it and start looking at the evidence. Now, the main evidence that floats around on other videos, and there's many other videos, many other people have done this video, but I have definitely got another edge on this video that I'll bring up a bit later, something new. But the main evidence is the fact that Biggie and Zaakir have the same moles. Now, if you look online, you'll see a lot of pictures with Biggie with no moles. So obviously, he's had them airbrushed out in a lot of pictures. But if you look on this one here, as it zooms in, you can see the moles. They're not as blatant as Zaakir Soup's, either, like, you know, bit of makeup on or whatever. But if you also notice the one by his left eye, just down from his left eye, Zaakir has the same mole just down from his left eye. So you have to look for the right pictures for those, but they're definitely there. Now, obviously, Soup Zaakir's nose is different, but like Akil's nose is different to Tupac's, they obviously get their nose done because it's like the thing that's noticed most obvious. So, but you know, so don't look for the things that are slightly different. Look for the similarities. Now, obviously, he's a lot slimmer than Biggie Smalls, who is a big guy. But he's now doing a thing called the Fully Love Collective, calling himself Fully Love. Not in a hidden way. He's open about this, his new project. But look how slim he is here. So, obviously, he can fluctuate weight, you know, from big to slim quite easily. Ideal if you're an actor. But take a look at this photo here. This is Soup Zaakir. Put some weight on. Look at his arms there. Looking a bit chubbier. So obviously, like I said, he can fluctuate between slim and big. And then, of course, looking into the connections, Biggie famously done Life After Death. Similar to Tupac, did his Machiavelli album, Notorious Big, told you what was going to happen. So Biggie supposedly died in March 97, which is, 6 months after or so after Tupac, which is a handy time transition for, like I said in the Akil video, I was at Jurassic 5's first UK gig, which was February 97. So Biggie supposedly died in March 97, which gave them a very good transition period to kill off those characters and become their new characters in the Jurassic 5. So here's a picture of him looking a bit chunkier here. So like I said, he obviously fluctuates weight. But whilst I was researching the Tupac Akil video, I came across this. Looking at the Tupac Snoop gig, I'm like, who's this guy? That guy looks like Biggie Smalls. But why would he be on stage with Tupac? As I said before, I was never really a Tupac fan. I was never really a Biggie fan. I liked some songs, but I was never really into them. So I didn't know who his crew were and who the members were. But this guy, a member of the Outlaws, his crew, was known as E.D.I. Mean, a play on the Ugandan president, E.D.I. Mean. So let's just have a look at a bit of him performing live. Yeah, man, he reminded me of an early Biggie, you know, before he got all into the sort of mafia sort of style look. Early street Biggie, that's what he reminded me of. But, and obviously there's Yaki Gaddafi in that video, Charlie Tuna. So I'm like, man, that's crazy. So I started looking into it a bit further. And, you know, similar ages, obviously 1972, Biggie was born. EDI Mean was born in 1974. I can't actually find the age of Soup Zaakir, but I know he's around the similar age. So I started looking a little bit further, looking at some interviews of this guy, EDI Mean, who I didn't really know. And there's a still here I got from a Vlad interview. And this is him, EDI Mean. Like I said, I didn't know who this guy was. So I didn't recognise him. I just saw this guy on stage and thought, he looks like Biggie. So I'm thinking, is this Zaakir playing another role? Being so blatant, being on stage with Tupac? Would they do that? Of course they would. Let's have a look a bit of EDI Mean's stuff that he released in, I think, 2020.
Yeah, we went from kings to niggas and back to kings now. Strictly for my niggas who notice how we swing now. No surprise, still I rise, lies never win. Sipping on Hen, reminiscing about my dead friends. I rap splendid for killers with football numbers. Crying mothers, hustlers and young dust kickers.
So yeah, I mean obviously straight away notice the horns he's put up. But I found a couple of videos of them talking, EDI Mean talking and Soup talking. And just listen to the sound of their voices.
The message resonates, man, beyond years, decades. It continues to live on because the conditions that he spoke about then continue to persist and continue this very day. So long as that happened, his message will always be relevant.
We do it, we enjoy it. They don't have to come. There's 1,000 people putting music out. They don't have to come to our show. You know, they don't have to buy the record they bought. So, you know, we appreciate that and we keep it moving. It's been how many years we done this? Like, close to 20 years.
Close to 20.
Out of the 20 years we done this, have you ever heard anybody say, I saw Jurassic and they was acting like shitheads to us? In 20 years, I'm a good actor, but I ain't that good.
I mean, they're blatantly the same people, the same voice, they look the same. Just a bit bigger, EDI means a bit bigger. But notice how he said about he's a good actor, but he's not that good. Well, to be honest, I think he is a pretty good actor because he's had a lot of people fooled, although now people are waking up to this stuff. But check the look that they've got from the video, from the Vlad video, and what he's wearing, the same glasses, just without the hat. But just check these out. I mean, you know. They're blatant. Same glasses, just without a hat. He's got a beard. Look at the nose, same person. And there he is with the horns again. But check this one out. I googled him, found this. I mean, this is EDI Mean. He's looking like Biggie there. He's looking like Biggie with the lips there. You know what I mean? Almost like they want us to find out because, you know, he's pouting there. He's looking like a Biggie pout. And then there's this, and a shout out to Tupac Theory. Again, it's an extensive amount of research. He's dedicated a whole channel to it. And I took this video from one of his videos, but just check this out.
There's a lot of people saying that you are Biggie Smalls.
That I am Biggie Smalls. I have.
But how did this even
come? I have.
I mean, there you go. He's Biggie Smalls. There's no doubt about that. But also, and I've not seen anyone else say that on a video, this on a video, he was also EDI mean and still is EDI mean. He's still doing that stuff. So, I mean, you know, he is a good actor. But, you know, anything that is said in darkness will always come to light. Peace!